Somebody nearly hit a fan along first base of the Coke bottle in the upper stand a moment ago. He could have got 10 points for that. Newcomb down, too high on Dark for a 2-2 count with one away. The Giants desperate, struggling for breath in the National League. 1-0 behind here. Brooklyn 1, the New York Giants nothing. Last half of the sixth inning. Now Don Newcomb into the windup. The Giant right-hander cuts it down, planks it in. Dark swings this one off the hole.
No, I stopped the clock across the first. Three. So the Great Billy Cox, playing great ball, makes the second saving stop of the afternoon. He got Stanky in the third inning on a double play stop inside the third baseline. Here he does it again to Alvin Dark to make a second out in the sixth inning. And now, with two away, Don Mueller is going to be the batter. He swings, hits one down the first baseline, foul, and it bounces toward the stands and out of play. The Dodgers written off three times the National League, not yet dead. None out, Mueller batting. 1-0 in favor of the Brooklyn Dodgers. Magley throwing the game of his life, but so is Newcomb. Tennant riding with every pitch in both these two teams.
Mueller will be swinging for that fence, I imagine, with two away. The strategy here would be to swing for a long ball. Greatest of all the National League pennant races has now been carried just as far as it can go. Each time, each team has saved its best bib and chucker for this last game. The sun trying to come out with the lights on. The pitch inside. 2-1. Two balls, one strike. Magley was 4-0 against the Brooks last year, 5-0 this year. Nuke is 4-3 against the Giants last year, 5-2 in this year. He's been beaten two out of his last three times out against the New York Giants, but today he is superb. Labine yesterday, no hit at the Giants the last five innings, so you can look and say that in the last 10 innings, the Giants have only had three hits off Brooklyn pitching. Newcomb works, delivering. Mueller swings, lets a pop up to the right side. Coming over for it is first baseman Hodges. Under it, waiting. He's got it for the out. And will Don Newcomb be able to ride that first inning Robinson single home to victory in the National League? That becomes the burning question of the moment. More flaming as the minutes wear on. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on base. We'll go into the seventh. Lucky for one of the two teams, perhaps, at the Polo Grounds with the score Brooklyn 1, the New York Giants nothing. Well, Dresden just asked Newcomb how he felt, and we could see Don's head nod in the affirmative. Magley goes out to the hill with a 4-0 record against the Brooks last year, 5-1 this year, trailing 1-0 on a first inning based on balls to Reese, one following the Snyder, and Jackie Robinson's electrifying single in the hole. Seventh inning of play, 40 home runs for the fellow up here. It's Gil Hodges, 270 hitter, outfield very deep, very much to the left. Magley twists the curveball too wide, one ball and no strikes. Down catching him, Wes Westrum, catching this afternoon for Brooks, Al Walker, whose performance for Campanella needs no apology. Ring is run out. Magley against Newcomb. Foul works. Hodges swings, and it's Nick Foul back in the screen. Boy, the wondrous terms of endearment that must be going on between these two teams down there on the field with $5,000 riding on the line for each player. We pause 5 seconds. This is the Liberty Broadcasting System. Back it is to the Polo Grounds, New York, with Liberty's game of the day, the final game of the day this year, because it can't go any further. They'll play all night to get this one over. Sal Magley kicks, throws, Hodges swings, lets the tall towering pop up, a weak soft drink fly back at home. Weston tightroping under it, boxes it in. One up and one down as Hodges pops to the catcher, and it is Billy Cox coming up now to see if he can write another page in his exploit book for this afternoon. He has made two fine fielding plays for the Brooklyn Dodgers, and along with Pee Wee Reese, it's been the big fielding gun. Let's listen to the applause for him. Here is Cox, who with Robinson has been the Dodger hatchet man today. He takes one inside. Robinson single. Bobby Thompson race into second base with the base already occupied. The base on balls to Reese. The great slaps by Cox and Reese. They are the highlights today. Billy takes ball two outside. Two balls, no strikes. 2-0. String running out. Sands of time running down the National League race. Billy Cox takes inside. Three balls, no strikes, one out.
Cox, the hitter, a good glove man. Bill Cox, number three, right-hand hitter. Rowe, if he should go in the World Series tomorrow, if the Dodgers should win, which is a long presumption, has still a sore arm. Here's a strike over there for a 3-1 count. He's got sore in Philly. He needs much more rest than he's been getting. This is one of those grimy New York afternoons. Dirty, wash, water, gray clouds above. Clearing up a little. Maglis 3-1 ball. Down the heart for a called strike. Right down the pipe. Sal Magley, the unsmiling, unflinching giant hero of 23 victories on the mound for the Polo Grounders this afternoon. Great will be the rejoicing in Flatbush if Newcomb can ride it through, but Magley is down and in with a 3-2 pitch hit down at the shortstop. Over his dark in perfect position, throws weakly to first in time for the out. That was almost a weak throw, but Dark looping it was right on the money with it. Two up and two down. The batter will be left-hand hitting Rube Walker, who unleashed a monumental over the right field upper deck home run here yesterday to match the exploit of shoeless Joe Jackson low those many years ago. The Barber still shaving with two away in the seventh inning, trailing 1-0. Black waters of the Harlem River back of the center field fence as Magley comes down through the murk with a ball one wide. One ball, no strike. Well, nothing has short-circuited this electric tension here today. Down at second, the cameo-sized second baseman, Stanky, calling to Magley, who throws. Ball two, a strike one over the outside corner. That caught it. One Dodger fan walked up to the bleacher line about 10 this morning, almost hidden by a 5-foot-high funeral piece of dahlias and gladiolas. It was draped in a black ribbon. Lettered in gold was the sentiment, sympathy to the Giants. Magley throws high and wide. Ball two, two and one. Two balls, one strike. Quicksand finale. One wrong step and down you go for keeps. New York and Brooklyn tied 97 wins and 59 losses apiece. Lights on. Magley looking down. Magic number for either team now one. The batter with two away. Left-hander Rube Walker who swings. Hits a bounding foul down past the first base coach Jake Pittler up against the stands and out of play. Out beyond out of play. So the New York Giants here. Battling, embattled, beleaguered, 1-0 behind. The first half of the seventh inning, the Giants will be up in the last half of the seventh inning. A tough ball game for both these pitchers. It'll be a heartbreaker for anybody who loses this one. Dodgers at the moment look happy as a pair of fleas in the dog pound. Two and two and two. Two balls, two strikes, two out. Rube Walker, the batter. Right-handed pitch. Walker cuts it. One in the hole. And Johnny Lockett goes racing over for it, but can't reach it. And around first, as fast as a prairie schooner pulled by a gopher, goes Rube Walker. Don Newcomb is the batter now. Newcomb, the Dodgers money winner, top slinger, huge man, hard worker, and a strikeout pitcher is up from Madison, New Jersey. Good hitting pitcher who often works in the bullpen between games, between starts. All-star star of 49 and 50, 6 feet 4, 220 pounds, left-hand hitter Don. Catcher Westrum down in catching position now. The outfield is short. In the Polo Grounds, every batter is a home run threat with the short fences. Magley works it down. Newcomb hits a sharp sparkler down to Eddie Sankey. Bottles picks up, throws quickly, in time to first base. That's all he has to do because Newcomb has given it up, rushing down the line. And they're booing Don as he walks back to the pitching mound right now because he didn't run that one out. Sankey had bobbled, but even had Don been at full tilt, he could not possibly have beat it to first base. 4-3. That's the out. Sankey to Lockwood. No runs, one Brooklyn single, lanced to right by Rube Walker, no errors, and Rube left spinning his wheels at first. Now, as we go down, 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 toward the final moment, the tip, the limit, the last jagged edge of the National League race. The score is one for the Brooklyn Dodgers, nothing for the New York Giants. Here's the right-hander Newcomb facing cleanup hitter Monty Irvin. Giant fans applauding for a rally, clapping. Hopefully, Monty Irvin crashes. Newcomb feeds, peeled off for a strike on the hip. Monty Irvin originally in outfield, but played a lot of first base for the Giants. Now back in left, lots of power, 6'1", 195 pounds. Leading runs batted in are the New York Giants, for that matter, in the National League also. A double-dive deep dish, Dozier in the pole, grass, Irvin swings, there's a line along the left field line, Castro comes over, it's off the wall, Castro plays it, Irvin around first, reaching the second, it's going to be close there, the throw, here's a wide throw, and Jackie Rupp plays a diving stop at second to keep it from going to three bases. The official paid attendance is only 34,320 held down for the weather, but there must be at least 15,000 addition to that here on Annie Oakley. Carol Whitey Lockman, blind, tall, rangy outfielder, standing deep in the box, feet close together. Newcomb checks Irvin, he throws, and it is punted. Off home plate, it's going to be called fair. Unlimbering in the Giants bullpen. This crowd, awfully excited, huh? Here's Bobby Thompson. They throw to third base for Monty Irvin, but he's standing on the bag. There was an attempted, that's not what it was. A look down there, Ron Cox returning to Newcomb. They were trying the hidden ball trick, but Irvin was on the bag. It didn't work. Newcomb throws, Thompson swings, and misses. Irvin down at third. Whitey Lockman up at first. Not out. And up is Bobby Thompson. Just dangerous as a great Dane behind a meat counter. Facing big Don Newcomb, the right-hander of the Brooklyn Dodgers, as drama and tension reign supreme in the Polo Grounds, New York. Bobby Thompson, the batter, the Royal Scot. A good thumper, right-hand hitter, doubled in an earlier inning, and then singled two hits. Swings, fouls it off at his feet. Two strikes. The Flying Scotsman, star outfielder. Outfield plays him deep over to the left. Broke in 46 to third base after 2 years in the minors. From Staten Island, New York, born in Glasgow, Bobby Thompson. Two on at third, Irvin, with the National League's tying run. We won't speak of it as the Giants' tying run. It's just the National League's tying run. This is a game between the first and the first place teams of the National League. Giants and the Dodgers. Dodgers and the Giants, depending on how you look at it. Lockman at first. Newcomb made a try at third. A desperate gambling shot. Trying to cut down a lead runner. They'd have to tag him down there. Didn't. Irvin was in safely on the try off of Lockman's butt. Lockman's at first on the field of charge. Runners first and third. Newcomb checks and throws to Thompson. Bobby swings. It's the dribbler. High bounding Baltimore chop. Down the third baseline past the Rocha foul. Fan reaches out and gets himself a souvenir of this tremendous playoff game in the National League. Boy, over on the Gowanus, the lilies must be drooping. Bodies must be floating down the canal like water. And a warm sun tries to peek out overhead with the light still shining. Excitement at its maximum. Bobby Thompson backs out of the batter's box. Newcomb is a good pitcher under fire. Don't underestimate him. You remember down in Philadelphia when he had the bases full, a tough man at that. And the count, 3-1 on the hitter, and still got out of it. Newcomb kicks, throws, Thompson swings, and lifts the pop up to the left, out of play, coming up on top of our Liberty Broadcasting System booth, foul. It's Irvin at third with a tying run. Whitey Lockman's at first. The infield is pulled in to play for the play at the plate. They want to cut off that winning run or the tying run. Irvin at third base. The outfield is very deep to the left. Crowd caught with suspense. Black shadow of calamity hanging over the Brooklyn Dodgers. The Brooklyn high tide of battle. 13.5 games long since gone. Down 3-1 in the National League. The magic number one for either team. All right. Black and the blue now, Bob. Lightning up overhead. Newcomb offers.
Up swings. That's a long drive. He's out of left field. That'll bring home the run. Back goes Snyder. He's under it, waiting. Irvin is tagged up. Here he comes into the plate. And it's a 1-1 tie in New York. Drifting fly, deep out in left field, sending Irvin home from third. Marty Lockman, who had a sacrifice in the fielder's choice, fighting in front of home plate to advance Irvin, where Black is scoring, is now Harbert still on first base, and Willie Mays is the batter. Mays, dramatic story being told here. A story that will linger 20 years, 50 years from now in baseball history. Mays takes time. All right. One man out, one man on, one run in. The one-up is Willie Mays. It's the seventh inning of play here at the Polo Grounds in New York. In a death struggle, a battle to the end between the Dodgers and the Giants.
Newcomb looks over toward Lockman. He throws down. Mays throws it right down the reef. He shovels the runner. It's one. They try for two. It's a double play.
Airtight Dodger infield again contains the New York Giants as Reese comes up with another saver, and the Dodgers reel off their second double play this afternoon. They have had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 line stops, 3 by Reese, 2 by Billy Cox. And now at the end of 7 innings, the New York Giants totals the last half of the 7th. Reese, 1 run, 1 base hit. A double by Monty Irvin, leading life in the Giants' comeback here since August the 12th. No errors, nobody left on base. And at the end of 7 innings here in the Polo Grounds, New York, in a misty, murky Harlem River afternoon, the score is Brooklyn 1, the New York Giants 1. First half of the 8th inning, first one-third of the Dodger order, first pitch by Magley. Swung on his right back swing, and he lines up. Carl Brillo on a line drive, bolting blast back to Magley's leather. Magley stopped it on the line. He was about chest high. Boom to him, and that would have undressed Sal unless he caught it in the leather. Pee-wee Reese, longtime Dodger favorite, will be up now. Defense will play him deep to the left. He's a steady hitter, an excellent fielder. The club's only 10-year man. Now Reese comes up. Feet spread, square stance, digs in. Acknowledged Dodger leader and field captain. The Dodgers won, the Giants won. Giants rallied to tie it for Magley. The Barber's pitch is hit down and over the head of Andy Stanky, bouncing in right field for base hit. Pee-wee Reese comes up with a single, banks out there and right. A closed line drive as Reese hung out the wash over Andy Stanky's sleeping fingers. Very fast, Duke Snyder comes on now. Has tremendous power, a left-hand hitter against the right-hand pitcher. And Magley will have to be very careful with the dangerous Snyder. With a short right field fence, only 297 feet down the line, 257 feet down the line. Jansen warming in the Giant bullpen, one on, one out. National League pennant riding down to the last 2 innings. The pitch swung on and missed. First half of the 8th inning, Duke Snyder waving at him. On deck, Jackie Robinson. Andy Papko down in the hole. Snyder up at the bat right now, one on, one out. The outfield is straight away. Eddie Stanky walks back to defensive position as Bobby Thompson comes into council with Magley. So we're going to have a little forum in session out on the mound.
Westrum out to talk to Magley. Here comes Alvin Dark, the Giants team captain, in also. Umpires, in case you didn't get them, who are watching placidly. Gets to third. Stewart at second. Jock O'Connell is to first. And Lou Jordan back of home. Boy, this crowd is really something. They will all be fit for straitjackets when this one is over. Dodgers and the Giants. Doing battle for the honor. A debt the seven clubs must pay in the National League. Doing battle down to the last ditch, to the last rampart. 1-1 going into the eighth inning of the end of the end of the end. One game, two games, three games after the end of the regular season. Just one day before the World Series, and it's still not decided, and it looks like that it might go on and on. Westrum goes back into the New York Giant dugout, and we may have a new New York Giant catcher coming on. Nope, it's going to be Westrum. He was just adjusting his paraphernalia. Rattling pressure. One of these two teams is at death's door in the National League in the eighth inning, and we still don't know who it is. Still don't know. Would you care to hazard a guess? I wouldn't. I wouldn't have the vaguest idea. As far as I'm concerned, this one is completely in the laps of the gods. If ever we have seen a National League pennant race which fits two completely evenly matched teams, this one is it. The Giants, in the closing stage of the campaign, were unquestionably the hottest team in the race. The Dodgers, in the first part, were head and shoulders above the field. Now in these three games, they're equal. Dead, even, Steven, equal. Bagley to Snyder, who swings, beats a whistling foul down past Whitman. A bouncer. Jake got out of the way, worried by that one. Now, Pee Wee Reese starts back to the bag. Strokes his chin. Westrum, walking part of the way back out the pitcher's mound, walks back down. Turns around, looks the batter. Guy's ready to crouch. Magley scuffing up the ball, the outfield straight away. The pressure's terrific. The Brooklyn Dodgers, caught stricken 2 days ago. Back now, trying to squelch the Giants. First half of the eighth inning, 1-1 tie. The pitch by Magley, offered down swing.
Hit it to home. Between first and second base, you reach, you can't get it. Here's Reese getting to third. He was thrown to third. He's not in time. He's in that spot. He's got to run it on first and third. One out. Jackie Robbins up here now. Reese at third, Snyder at first, Jack Robbins the hitter, and Steve Pasco on deck. And now out comes Leo DeRocher to talk to the barber, who right now is being given a rather close shave himself by the Brooklyn Dodgers. That was a hard hit shin smacker, flanked by Duke Snyder, past Stanky. Jackie Robbins, the good hitting second baseman of the Brooklyn Dodgers, with a 337 batting average and one hit and two times at bat today. Three hits yesterday, one the day before. A game-winning home run the day before that on Sunday is up to now, waiting outside the batter's box in the blue uniform of what the Brooklyn Riders are calling the stalwart line of blue. Val Magley on the hill. I will tell you about it pitch by pitch now. Robin's stop at Journey's End of the National League, trying to strike the fatal blow. Magley in deep trouble. The great barber pitching the mask to Robinson is high and wide with his first one. One ball, no strikes. 1-0. The greatest day of them all in National League history. The greatest game of them all. Robinson batting. It gets away from Westrum. Reese racing in the score. Here is Snyder around second, heading for third. The throw there is not in time. He's at third. The Dodgers lead 2-1. Wild pitch. The Giants cause at this moment would appear a lost cause. They trail 2-1. Runner on third. One out. Wild pitch by Bagley. Which hit low in the dirt. Bounced back behind Winston to the screen. Sent Reese racing home to score. And Snyder from first to third. Robin swings at one foul. Back and out of play. Bagley, imperturbable right-hander, having been here this afternoon just a couple of times service apparently, throws the loss back to the ground in disgust. Bagley was pitched in all kinds of weather, in all kinds of situations, a logical choice for the big one here today.
The last day of the regular season, the battle of Coogan's Bluff with the Giants being slowly pressed. 2-1, the Dodgers lead them. At first, Robinson, on third, Snyder. Andy Pascoe on deck. So, a moment ago, the Giant hopes were shining so brightly. Now are so bleak, so dreary. Strike called on Pascoe. Nothing in one. One out. Hodges on deck. Tough part of the Dodger order up here in the eighth inning. The Giants, in the last half of the eighth, will have Westrum, Magley, or a pinch hitter for him. Probably the pinch hitter. Then Eddie Sankey. Then the tough part of their list in the last half of the ninth inning. Val Magley kicks and throws. Swung on, beaten down the third base line. Followed by Bobby Thompson. Gets away from him in foul territory. Goes as an error. Left side to the plate. Dodgers lead 3-1.
Well, Bobby Thompson, the Giant outfielder turned infielder. Bottles a hard hit, stuff the handle grounder down the third baseline. It goes as narrow. Pascoe is on. Robinson beats the second. Dodgers lead 3-1. As Snyder comes off. The pitch cut on and missed wickedly by Snyder, who was churning from the heels. 3-1 in favor of the Dodgers. First half of the eighth inning. The Giants have 6 outs left. The National League race. Coslow has joined Jansen with the Giant bullpen. Unquestionably now, there will be a pinch hitter from Magley in the last half of the eighth inning. The desperate fighting. The Giants trying to rally their shattered remnants for a last stand of the last half of the eighth and ninth. One strike to count on Hodges, who swings just to pop up down the third baseline. They're waiting for it as Thompson. Robinson is having to hustle back towards second base. He'll make it, though, and Thompson grabs the ball for the out. Two away. Runner still at first base and second base. Robinson on second, Pascoe on first. We pause 10 seconds for station identification to remind you that you are listening to America's newest network, the second largest network in the world on its first birthday, the 431 station Liberty Broadcasting System. Well, the best laid plans of mice and men gang up the clay. And even with the choice of Sal Magley, the Dodgers have been able to lead 3-1 here in the last half of the eighth. Sal delivers. Scott Green went down and threw Thompson off his glove in the left field. Robinson to right third on his way into the fourth Dodger run. Holding a second. Pascoe Dodgers lead 4-1. First trying for the third out and catches there to lock them. 4-3 on Walker. One of the Dodgers who has 2 unearned runs in the inning. The last 2 runs being unearned. The Dodgers have 3 runs, 3 hits, 1 error by the New York Giants, and a costly error by Bobby Thompson. It may prove to be 2 men left on base. Going into the last half of the eighth, and one of the final 2 chances for the New York Giants from the vanishing National League race to score. Brooklyn 4, the New York Giants 1. The matching boy, Bill Rigby, is batting for West Weston as we open the last half of the eighth inning as the Giants go down the last mile. The Dodgers may have just served a death warrant. Burlow, line to the pitcher to open the eighth, an uneventful beginning, but then Reese singled to right. Snyder followed with another quick single, and with men on first and third, with one out, Val Magley wild pitched Snyder home. Dodgers led 2-1. Robinson walked. There were men then on first and third with one out still. Thompson made an error on Papko's ground. Another run came in. Bencock singled on another run. There's a pitch over there for a call strike as the Brooklyn fans roar, roar, roar. Signs go up everywhere. Go, Dodgers, go. Hank Thompson was on deck. Right-hand hitter here. Bill Rigney, the bat of the basketball, chokes the bat. The outfield's off the left. Got a quick 2 call on the outside corner. Rigney backs out. On deck is Hank Thompson, who will hit for Sal Magley. Donkey Thompson will hit for Sal Magley. Magley will no longer be a factor in the game's winning. Newcomb into the big pumping motion. Big Don brings it down. Swung on and gets for strike three. That's all for Bill Rigney. And up comes Sal Magley. Or rather, Donkey Thompson, as we've told you, hitting for Sal Magley. On deck, Sankey, down in the hole, dark. Giants fighting the final summons. Well, the Giants, who showed a heart of oak and winning 38 of their last 46 games up until today, paper being thrown out in left field out of the stands, littering the field. Dodger supporters beginning to celebrate, perhaps a little bit precipitously. The Giants facing extinction in the National League race. They are four outs away. Thompson swings, hits one down to the right side. Hodges goes over backhand. Newcomb's over to Jefferson. Hodges fed to his right, made a good backhand drop, halfway back on the skin of the infield. Two-thirds of the way over towards, or one-third of the way over towards second. Slap the ball, skin it, and putting on the chains, turned around, threw a perfect precision spot throw to Big Newcomb, rushing over to his left to cover first on the loft for the out. 3-1. And now Eddie Sankey is the batter from Mobile, Alabama. Leo's pride and joy. Dangerous clutch man. Plenty of hustle. Newcomb throws across the outside corner for a strike on Sankey. The valorous New York Giants in peril. As the Dodgers, bearding the Giant in his den, lead 4-1, last in the eighth, Sankey batting. Little fellow waits, cocks, and then does it offer as the ball sails over the head of catcher Walker for ball one. 1-1. Newcomb is putting tremendous speed on every pitch. His arm seems to be completely loose. Completely. Crowd hopping around like a bunch of floor walkers in Macy's basement. Here comes Newcomb, down with it. Sankey swings with a high pop-up to the left side. Dashing overboard is Reese along the line. Reese is up and holds it in for the opposite side of the side. The Giants are on the full drive in the eighth inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on. At the end of the game, don't turn your radio set off if you hear loud, strange noises. It'll be the fans calling in. At the end of eight innings here, at the Polo Grounds in New York, the Dodgers 4, the Giants 1. Now Sal Magley throwing a few scattered boos as he goes up the dressing room steps. He is being relieved here now by Larry Jensen, who the Giants hope would start the first game of the World Series against the New York Yankees tomorrow across the Harlem River at Yankee Stadium, which now for the Giants looms as misty and far away across that Harlem River from where we are sitting as the Taj Mahal. Jansen, considered by many as the best pitcher in the big time today. Sterling right-hander. He can knock a fly off a bat at 60 feet. Walked only an average of one man every four innings. Has great control, a good hop on his batsman, a good curve, a good slider. So here, quiet, unassuming family man, Larry Jansen from Forest Grove, Oregon, to pitch the top half of the ninth inning against the Brooklyn Dodgers with Raphael Noble. Noble fell as though it was pronounced Noble, doing the catching for the Giants. A new battery. Jansen, Noble. Don Newcomb getting a fine hand to the crowd. Let's do him still. Newcomb swinging for the Dodgers. First half of the ninth inning, Giants trail 4-1. Jansen pitches and Larry hits the inside corner for a strike. Boy, I'll be 7 sardines in a size 6 can if this isn't honey. Brooklyn 4, the New York Giants 1. First half of the ninth inning. Jansen offers Newcomb, hits one weakly to the right. Stanky comes in fast for it. Collins it, gobbles, throws to first. Guns it in there in time for the out. Wending our way tortuously toward that last half of the ninth inning, which will be the beginning. 4-3 for the out. Carl Ferrillo, Brooklyn Dodger batter. Ferrillo led off in the eighth inning. Drove a screamer right back into the hands of Magley at that time, and it looked like the eighth inning was to be a routine frame. But then the Dodgers broke open like a ripe watermelon. Jansen trying to preserve the vestige of a giant chance. Throws. Ferrillo hits one weakly to the left side. A ground skinner picked up by Dark, who angles the throw on the right field side of first to the reaching Whitey Lachman, who hauls it back for the out. Now two up and two down. It will be left to Pee Wee Reed in the regular National League season now to keep the Dodgers alive in the ninth inning. This may be the last Dodger batter up in the regular National League season. A great ball game that they'll be talking about down through National League history for many, many years to come, down through baseball history. Jansen throws it down, reads it, the long, long drive out in center, but Willie Mays is loping back, will be able to get out, turns around, swallows it to the out to retire the side. It'll be the last half of the ninth inning, and a dramatic last half it should be. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base. And now the Giants, strangling, struggling for breath, three outs away from extinction in the National League race, will come up in the last half of the ninth inning with a score of Brooklyn 4, the New York Giants.